हेलो गाइस, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड। आई एम विशाली किकान एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग द VLSI टेक्नोलॉजी। इन दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग द केमिकल मैकेनिकल पॉलिशिंग और द CMP। एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू द CMP। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू हैव वॉच द प्रीवियस वीडियोज ऑन द CMP, एंड इफ नॉट इट इज़ हाईली रिकमेंडेड दैट यू गो बैक एंड वॉच द प्रीवियस वीडियोज वंस एंड देन कम टू दिस वीडियो। So we are starting the today's lecture, but before starting, one more thing I want to say that if you are not watching this video very carefully, you should provide your utmost attention because this video is going to be really informative one. I want all of your attention to be coming to this video and I want you to watch each and every part of this video because you cannot miss anything. All of the topics that we are going to cover are really important. So we are going to talk about the four parts about the CMP basics. First is removal rate, then uniformity, selectivity, and at last we are going to talk about defects. So all of them are really important. We are going to have some in-depth analysis of all of them. So first of all, we are starting with the removal rate. So as you might be guessing, the removal rate is the rate by which I am removing the layer. Which layer I am removing? The rough layer I am removing. I know in the CMP I am removing the uppermost rough layer of the wafer, right? And by the rate by which I am removing the uppermost rough layer of the wafer is the removal rate. So mechanical removal rate is also known as removal rate. So it's the other name of the removal rate and it is denoted by R, and its mathematical equation was given by a scientist called Preston. So what did Preston do? Preston gave a mathematical equation. According to the Preston equation, the removal rate R is equal to Kp into P into OV. Okay, OV is the relative velocity of the wafer with respect to the polishing pad. We all know that if I have the polishing pad and the wafer is there, either both of them are moving the circular direction or one of them is moving the linear direction or other is moving in the circular direction. So there is some relative velocity in between both of them. So OV is the relative velocity of wafer and the polishing pad. After that we have P. P is the pressure that we are applying on the wafer holder. I have already talked about this pressure in the last video. Okay, so I can say P is the polishing pressure, and here one more term is there, that is Kp. So Kp is the Preston coefficient. So now from this equation you can observe that R is directly proportional to P. So if I increase the pressure, then the removal rate is going to increase. Okay, so this thing must be clear. So now the Preston equation is working really well for the bulk film polishing process, right? If I want to polish a bulk film, I can use the Preston equations. The protruding portion on a rough surface have higher polishing pressure because if I have more height and if I am sending the same pressure, the portion which are having the more height will experience more pressure. Right, so the protruding portion on the rough surface will be having higher polishing pressure, which means the removal rate of the protruding portion would be higher, and this will be helping me to remove the surface topography, and thus at the end it is going to planarize the surface. So at the last I am going to get a planar surface because the topographies are removed. There we were experiencing more pressure, which means the removal rate was more at the rough topographies. Okay, so this thing must be clear. So you can see here, this thing is the same thing with the help of the diagram. So this is my polishing pad. Okay, so here this is the protruding portion. Here I will be experiencing high pressure. So here we will be having the faster removal. Similarly, here this is the protruding portion, and again here I will be having the faster removal and the high pressure. Okay, so this is the plane surface, and here we will not be having any kind of pressure because it is not in contact with the polishing pad, and here from this portion I will not be having any kind of removal. So the removal will be from the protruding portion, and in turn what will happen, we will be getting a planar surface. So the thickness difference between द इनिशियल फेज एंड द फाइनल फेज ऑफ द सीएमपी, और बिफोर एंड आफ्टर ऑफ द सीएमपी इज डिवाइडेड बाय द सीएमपी टाइम एंड दिस इज हाउ आई एम गेटिंग द रिमूवल रेट. सो आई होप दिस इक्वेशन और दिस डेफिनेशन इज क्लियर. प्रेस्टन इक्वेशन इज क्लियर and the removal rate definition is now clear. So now we can measure the removal rate at different points also depending upon the uniformity. So we can have different uniformity. If the uniformity is same, then I may not be measuring the removal rate at the different points because the pressure would be same there. But if I have some different uniformity or if I have the rough surface, I will be calculating the removal rate at each and every point and I will be finding out at which point I will be having the higher removal rate. Like in this picture I told you, this is the protruding portion, here I will be having higher removal rate. So we can have any test wafer and we can find out what is the removal rate for the test wafer, and this is how I can apply this on any application, practical application of a real wafer. So we can use any test wafer to find out the removal rate and then I can use it for our practical application. So I will be getting the blanket film at the last, and you can see the removal rate is a very important factor which classify any type of CMP process. So now coming to the uniformity. Uniformity is usually measured about the various roughness which are present. So if I want to say that any wafer is rough or any wafer is planar, how I can measure that? With the help of uniformity. So generally 49.3 sigma standard deviation is the commonly used definition of the uniformity for the CMP process qualifications. So I will be having 49 points on the wafer over which I am going to measure the various parameters, and then I am going to see the difference between the measured parameter. If the difference is high, I will be saying the wafer is not uniform. If the thickness is, or if all of the parameters are not changing much, then I can say, like one parameter could be thickness, right? So if the thickness is not changing much, I can say the wafer is uniform, or in this case I can say the wafer is planar. The changes of the film thickness before and after CMP process is monitored, and the uniformity also before and after the CMP process will be monitored. So uniformity before the CMP process would be higher, or uniformity after the CMP process would be higher? This is a question for you. So the uniformity after the CMP process would be higher because we will not be getting many changed parameters at different points after the CMP process because of the planarized structure. Okay, for the production wafers, uniformity after CMP process is monitored with the help of 9 or 13 points, right? So before I am taking 49 point measurement, and after we are taking 9 or 13 point measurement. We are considering within the wafer or wafer to wafer uniformity also. So both of them can be affected by the polishing pad condition. What kind of polishing pad we have? We had already discussed about this in the previous video also, that if I have a harder polishing pad, it is going to give me the faster removal rate, plus it is going to give me a more planar structure. So after that, it is going to be affected with the downforce pressure distribution. After that, the relative speed between the pad and the wafer. And after that, it is going to get affected by the restraining ring positioning and also the shape of the wafer. So if I am using harder pad and the lower pressure, I will be getting a good global uniformity, right? The lower pressure and the lower removal rate affect the throughput, okay? So now coming to the next parameter, that is selectivity. Selectivity is the ratio of removal rate of different materials. So my wafer can be having the same material, or it might be having the different material at different locations. Like we have the metallization layer, we have the CMP layer, we have the dielectric layer as well. So these different kind of layers will be having different removal rate with the same process. So this is called the selectivity. The rate of removal will be higher for a particular type of substance and it would be lower for some different type of substance. So it affects the CMP defects such as erosion or dishing. I am going to talk about both of them. What is erosion? What is dishing? I am going to talk about both of them. So the slurry chemistry is the primary factor that is affecting the removal selectivity of the CMP process. Okay, so if I want to change the selectivity, I have to look to the slurry and I can change the composition of the slurry and then I can change the selectivity. So if there is a problem of selectivity, then we have to check the slurry. So short trench isolation oxide CMP require high oxide to nitride selectivity, as high like 100:1 to 300:1. Because only polished oxide selectivity is not important in PMD and IMD CMP process, right? So this is the reason we have high selectivity requirement. Now for tungsten CMP process, selectivity to oxide and titanium nitride is again very important. Right, so whenever we are doing the CMP for tungsten also we have to see the selectivity as well. So tungsten to TEOS oxide selectivity is very high, from around 50 to 200, and again we have to see the slurry chemistry. If tungsten is going to remove more than the TEOS, or TEOS is going to remove more than the tungsten, then again we are not getting a planar structure, we are getting some roughness that we don't want. So we have to again see the slurry chemistry, we have to see the various oxidants also. So selectivity is also related to the pattern density, right? At which point I have more patterning and which point I have less number of patterning, that I'm going to show you with the help of pictures. So if I have higher patterning or higher pattern density, so that time I will be having lower removal selectivity. So it leads to the erosion of the tungsten and the oxide film. So you can see here, we have the higher pattern density. So here we have tungsten layer, then oxide layer, tungsten layer, oxide layer. So here you can see we have more erosion. And here we have tungsten and oxide. We have lesser density of the tungsten and oxide layer. You can see we have lesser removal over here. So IC layout and the erosion. How the erosion is going to affect the IC design layout. So erosion is directly affecting the IC design layout. So it will be causing some problems. So what it can cause? It will be leading to the formation of some opening areas less than 30% of the chip surface. You can see here we have high density. Here we have tungsten layer, then oxide layer, tungsten layer, oxide layer, tungsten layer, oxide layer, and here we have lesser density tungsten and oxide layer, right? So you can see we have different removal rate over here. So this is how we can see the difference in the removal rate caused by the pattern density, right? So now coming to the IC layout and the erosion. Okay, so how the IC layout is going to cause the erosion and how we can eliminate this process. So IC design layout can directly affect the erosion problem that we have already seen, that if I have more density, I will be having less removal rate and this is going to cause the erosion problem. So by designing opening area less than 30% of the chip surface, it can help to solve the erosion problem. So now coming to the last topic of the day, that is defects. So the CMP removes the defect and it is going to improve the yield, but in turn it is going to give me some defects as well. So with the help of CMP process, we are going to generate some defects also, like the scratches. We will be having the residual slurry present on the wafer. We will be having some particles, erosion and dishing. We have already talked about erosion. Now I hope you understand what is erosion. We are going to talk about dishing as well. So if I have large foreign particles and hard polishing pad, it will be causing the scratches on the wafer. That is undesirable. So if I use a harder polishing pad, it is going to give me higher removal rate, but it is going to give me scratches as well. So tungsten fills the scratches in oxide surface and can cause the short circuit and reduce the IC yield. Okay, so this is how I have to avoid the formation of scratches. So the tungsten might not go there, it might not make the IC to be short circuited, and thus it not be affecting the IC yield. Okay, if I have improper downward force, or if I have worn out pad, if I have any inadequate pad conditioning, if I have particle surface attraction, if I have slurry drying, all of these are causing the defects. So these are the main causants of the defects. So because of all of these reasons, the defects are arising on the wafer. Slurry residue on the wafer surface also cause the contamination of the wafer with the slurry. So post CMP clean is very important to remove the slurry residue and to improve the process yield. So now coming to the erosion. What is erosion? Erosion is going to increase the depth of the wire holes. I hope you remember what is erosion. So we will be having the incomplete wire hole etch, okay, during the erosion process. Okay, open loop will be there in between the different layers, and the next layer, dual damascenes interconnection. So you can see how the circuit opening is caused by the erosion. So you can see here at the lower layer we were having the erosion due to the density of the different layers. So here we were having higher density, here we were having lower density. So here you can see we were having interconnection in between the via holes, but here we are having some open circuiting caused by the erosion, because the copper penetration will be same at this part and at this part, but here the removal was more, and here you can see the copper layer is not reaching up to the tungsten, and this is how we were having some opening caused due to the erosion. So now coming to the dishing effect. So dishing effect is happening when I have a larger opening area of the wafer. So it happens also because of the larger metal pads, as well as if I have the shallow trench oxide present in the trenches. If I have more material which are removed from the center, then my wafer is going to look like a dish, and this is called the dishing effect. We are removing the more material from the center of the wafer, and it is resulting in the conversion of the wafer in the form of a dish. So cross section view look like a dish. You can see here if I have this cross section, it is looking like a dish, and this is called the dishing effect. So now coming to the dishing, erosion and the selectivity. So both dishing and erosion are related to the removal selectivity. Both are related to the selectivity. If I have lower selectivity or higher selectivity, at which point I will be having more erosion and more dishing. You can think about it and you can post it in the comments. So now if I have the tungsten CMP process, if tungsten to oxide selectivity is too high, then more tungsten is going to remove and it is going to cause dishing as well as recessing. If the selectivity is not that high, both oxide and tungsten will be polished and it is going to cause the erosion. So we have to take the selectivity in between. We cannot take the selectivity too high, we cannot take the selectivity too low. So oxide CMP with high selectivity of oxide to nitride can also cause oxide dishing during the oxide over polishing step of the oxide CMP in the shallow trench isolation formation. So you can see this is the shallow trench isolation formation, and here we have the dishing effect of STI USG layer. Okay, because of the selectivity problems, right, in the oxide and the nitride. So now coming to the particles and the defects, how the defects are caused by the particles. So particle and defects cause irregular topography on the wafer surface. So in turn we are generating again the rough surface of the wafer. Why we were doing the CMP? To remove the rough surface, and with the help of particle contamination we are again getting the rough surface. So this is a very dangerous thing for our wafer and it is going to scatter the incident light. Okay, so how we are going to monitor the defects? The monitor of particles and the defects is done by detecting this scattered light itself. So you can see how the particle detection is done by the light scattering. So you can see here we have the substrate. Okay, so you can see we are having the incident light. Incident light is going to the substrate, right? And we have the scattered light. So you can see we have the reflected light. So if the surface was even, so in that case I will be getting this reflected light only. But if I have a particle defect present on the surface, then this incident light is going to reflect from the particle surface, plus it is going to scatter from the particle surface as well. And here at the photodetector, I am going to detect the scattered light as well. So particle detection by the light scattering is done to find out where we have the particle contamination present on the substrate. So now coming to the particle measurement. So how we can measure how many particle contaminants are present? First of all, we can measure the intensity of the scattered light. If the intensity is weak, we can say that we have less particle contamination. If intensity is more, which means I have scattered light coming from a lot of particles, which means I have a lot of particle contamination. Elliptical mirror is also used to collect the light, and I know elliptical curve has two focus. Light from the one focus reflect to the another focus in this case. And now the laser beam scans the wafer surface vertically at one focus of the elliptical mirror, and a photo detector is placed at the another focus. So light was moving from one focus and going to the another focus, and we have placed the photo detector at the another focus so that the photo detector is going to detect how many or what is the intensity of light or how many rays are coming to the another focus. So moving the wafer and collecting the scattered light to detect tiny particles and the defects would be the best technique to measure the particle contaminants. We can map the particle, we can find out the defect location on the wafer surface also. So you can see how we are doing the laser scan. You can see we are sending some incident light. Incident light is sent here. The reflected light will be sent after in the same direction. After reflecting from the wafer, we are having the reflected light back in the same direction, right? So this is my elliptical mirror, and at the another focus we have placed the photo detector. This is my wafer with some particle contaminants. So now I have to measure how many number of particles are there. So I am going to scan the wafer from the starting, and like if I don't have any particle contaminants, the reflected light will be going back from this opening only, and we will not be having any light detected on the photo detector. So you can see as soon as the light is coming on this particle, so this is going to scatter the light. I have already told you, if the particle is experiencing some light incident on it, it is going to scatter the light, and this light is going to focus on the next focus. This is at the next focus we have the photo detector. It is going to detect that yes, now I have a particle contaminant. Okay, in the similar fashion we can again scan, and as soon as the another particle contaminant is coming, what will happen? Again at the photo detector I will be going to detect the scattered light from this particle contaminant. Okay, and this is how I will be getting to know that there were two particles which were contaminant particles on the given wafer. So I hope you understood the various things about this topic. You have now understood various basics of the CMP in detail. If you have any doubt, you can put the doubt in the comment, or if you want to understand this topic in detail, you can refer these books. These are really amazing books that we have. Or you can put the doubt in the comment, and I am going to talk to you or reply to you as soon as possible. I hope you like this session. If you like it, please push the like button, subscribe to the channel, and also do share it with your friends. Thank you so much.